But me and my fella try and be romantic to each other whenever we feel like it. Sometimes we celebrate Valentine's Day, sometimes we don't. We didn't this year, we did last year. Last year, a few days before Valentine's Day, he said to me, I could do with some suggestions sort of on the present front. And I said, that's fine, because I know some women like a surprise, but I'm quite happy to know what it is, because I'm really busy and I don't have time to take the bugger back. So I said to him, I said, there's a shop called Accessorize that I love. I said, you could pretty much get anything in there and you'd be on safe ground. I described the kind of thing that I like. I said, it's relatively inexpensive costume jewellery. Sort of this sort of thing, sort of beads and little flowery earrings, sort of quite plasticky, quite girly, you know, quite cheap. Nothing that looks like actual jewellery. And he said, fine, logged. I do love him, but that's what he's like, logged. And off he went. And I want to show you what he bought us. Bear in mind, the last thing I said to him was nothing that looks like actual jewellery. First thing he bought us was 9 pairs of identical diamond earrings. And just in case I was thinking, well, that's not enough diamond earrings for a girl who's got her ears pierced just the once. Another 3 pairs of almost identical diamond earrings. And any ladies might well have noticed, especially near the front, that they're not from Accessorize, they're from Claire's Accessories. So I said to him, they're lovely, thank you. But you didn't... So you didn't make it to Accessorize then? He said, I went to the girl shop. I said, yes, it's a 12-year-old girl shop. I reminded him that that's where we got presents for his nieces, who were 11 and 12, and he went, yeah, because they're girls. His logic was brilliant. I thought he must have walked in Claire's Accessories and gone, she wants anything from in here. I'm probably lucky that he didn't come home with a tiara with fucking kittens on it. He said, there's something else in the bag. Oh, great. He said, I got you a couple of bangles. I said, they're earrings. He said, they're bangles. I said, they're earrings. They're like, I'm off to McDonald's and I want to fit in. I said, they've got a little hinge so that you can get them in your ears. He said, that's so that you can get them on your wrists. He thought of everything, apart from anything I told him. I said, I just hope that when you got to the till, you didn't tell the lady that they were for your girlfriend, because if you did, you might well be on some kind of fucking register now. Alone, I really liked it. I really like living alone. But one of the things I love about living with somebody else again is I like the unpredictability of it. I like that every now and again a sentence will come out that I would never have said. The most recent one, out of Norway, he just went, your shed's no good to have a wank in. And I said, that's because it's a greenhouse, love. I was on holiday with my boyfriend last year and he lifted me up like in a romantic fashion, you know, and put me down again, obviously, in a different place. Otherwise that would just be weird, wouldn't it? Like the guest the way to the lady stall at the fairground. Too fucking much! And when he put me back down, because I'd been reading a bit of Jane Austen on holiday, I came over all sort of... like I needed a fan. And I said, was I very heavy? And he's supposed to follow the lead and say something along the lines of, why, you weighed no more than a dried leaf. Well, he didn't. He went, manageable. But like I say, I've been with my fella for 6 years. It's going really well. He bought himself a suit recently. I don't think I've ever seen him in a suit. I quite fancied him in his suit. And I told him, I said, quite fancy you in your suit. And he said, and I quote, it's very smooth, he said, if you like, I'll leave it on and sort you out all good and proper, all posh and that. He said, you forgot to say Miss Moneypenny on the end. But the only time we ever argue is when it comes to Christmas, birthdays, present-giving times, that sort of thing, because he really likes to buy me surprises and I really hate surprises. We've got a bit of a happy medium now, though, the last couple of years, where I give him a list of pre-approved surprises. 5 or 6 things. He can pick whichever one he likes. I don't know which one it's going to be, so it's still technically a surprise. He came home a few days before my birthday last year, and he said, never guess what I've just done. I said, what have you just done? He said, I've gone off list. He said, I'm not even sure if you're going to like it. I said, why the fuck did you buy it then? I mean, thank you. But a friend of mine who doesn't really know us very well, she said, oh, that sounds like an engagement ring to me. I said, no, it sounds like kaplunk. But I told you I live on my own. My boyfriend also lives on his own. I think some people think that's quite odd that we've been together a few years and we don't live together. But we sort of feel like we've got the best of both worlds because we have a few days a week together and a few days a week apart, and it's sort of ideal. There was a time that he moved in with me for 3 months because he was between flats and it made sense. And I was fine with it because there was an end date. I'm a bit stuck in my ways. I love you, but bye. And while he was at mine for those 3 months, I worked away for a week, and when I came back, some things had changed in my flat. And I said, love, one of the towels smells of bums. You got any idea what that might be? Without even thinking, he just went, that'll be me bum towel. When he did eventually move out, there's a housewarming present. I brought him a small brown hand towel. It's good because it's brown. He doesn't have to wash it. He can just crack it and use it again. But I live in a flat. I live in a block of flats. And I came out the front door a few months ago and there was just a shoe on the pavement. You've all seen that happen. Just a lone shoe. And you just think, I wonder what happened there. And then you carry on with your day, which is exactly what I did. But a week goes by, and the shoe is still there. It's now joined by a man's shirt. A couple of days after that, same shoe, same shirt, pair of man's pants. Now that is one woman just really slowly dumping her boyfriend. Am I going to come out in 6 weeks' time? There's going to be a big pile of clothes and just a severed cock on the top. I mean, I haven't dumped anybody in a while. Is that still how we do it, girls? Is it? Yes, it is. Oh, good to know. Thank you. But he is a lovely man. He's lovely. We were in bed the other day and he got quite animated. And he shouted out, feel how hard that is. And I thought, you bugger, it's Tuesday, we didn't have this booked in. Turns out he's talking about the skin on his feet. I thought about taking him to one of those places, you know those places that are popping up all over the place where it's got a tank with the fish in and you put your feet in and the fish nibble at the hard skin, you know those places. And I thought about taking him to one of those and I thought, I can't do that. The poor little fish, they'll think he's got fucking shoes on. I'm just going to take him to a blacksmith instead. But he's lovely. He's the nicest person I've ever met. He's a genuinely good man. And in January this year, I said to him, you know what? I think it's about time we started talking about the future. And that's what I expected from him, like an awkward silence. Maybe some footsteps as he walked the fuck out of my life. But he didn't. He just smiled. Just really like a beaming grin. And I was really touched. And I thought, oh, my God, he wants to spend his future with me. Yay. I said, are you sure you're all right talking about the future? And he went, what, like flying cars and that? But we have quite busy lives, as I'm sure a lot of you guys do too. And when we go on holiday, we like to go somewhere relaxing, somewhere where we can look at nice scenery and read books. That's all we really want to do. My boyfriend doesn't like to fly, so we tend to stay within the UK. And because we don't have to pay for expensive flights, we sometimes treat ourselves to a slightly posher hotel. And the last posh hotel we stayed in had two baths either side of each other. And I thought, oh, we're going to be able to have really romantic baths together without having to stare at hairy toes. That man puts up with an awful lot with me. To be fair, his feet aren't any better. They're not horrific, they're just, you know, feet. Nails are a bit long, toes are a bit hairy. There's crusty bits on the bottoms, you know this sort of thing. So you look like you could pick up mice with those. They've got a certain sort of owl-like quality to them. But you know, we don't live together. We have a few days a week together and a few days a week apart. And when we're apart and I get to sleep in my own bed on my own, I fucking love it. Starfish! I love it. So we all have our partners, but when you're trying to get to sleep, they all do niggly things, don't they? Like breathing. 30 years together, is there anything about each other when you're trying to get to sleep that's irritating? He snores, does he snore? Gives a chill to people who think that they're a snorer. Well, the people who know they're sitting beside a snorer. Yeah. There's a bit of denial in the room tonight. My boyfriend snores. And I found out recently that my dad also snores, because I was whinging to my mum about my boyfriend snoring. And she said, have you tried these? And then slid something across the kitchen bench like it was drugs. Try these. And what they were those nasal strips. I don't know if you've seen them. They're little strips that go across the bridge of the snorer's nose so that they open the nostrils out so that they can breathe more clearly. And in theory, they don't snore anymore. Now, they worked for us for a while until it came to Christmas. Now, something you need to know about me is that I really love Brussels sprouts. My boyfriend doesn't like Brussels sprouts. So at Christmas, we get a big bag of Brussels sprouts and I eat the lot. And I don't mind telling you, I'm pretty fucking toxic. So just before we went to bed on Christmas night, my boyfriend went, do you mind if I don't put the strip on tonight? I don't want my nostrils to be any bigger than they have to be. Another thing he does, he puts his arm across us, and I quite like that, because I feel quite sort of safe and protected, I suppose. But then sometimes he puts his leg across, and I think, oh, now we are taking the fucking piss. The last time I did it, he put his foot, remember, I described it not that long ago, he put his foot on my leg, and he rubbed it up and down. And I went, what are you doing? And he went, I'm being tender. I said, no, love, you're exfoliating. Well, the bit of advice I've got is for the ladies in the room. I've discovered as a woman how you know whether or not you're overweight. It's during the throes of passion when your partner picks you up, whether or not they say 1, 2, 3 first. It's my favourite joke. It's getting less funny as the days go on. Hello, I'm Sarah Millican, and thanks very much for watching my videos. I'm going on tour with a brand new show called Bobby Dazzler. For all the information about where I'm going and when, go to sarahmillican.co.uk. Thanks!